I'm interested in the mesopelagic, which is one of the least studied components of the ocean ecosystem. This area is deeper than where sunlight allows plants to grow, but there is some light allowing animals to see. The fish in this zone account for more than half of the total fish biomass on our planet, and yet we've never exploited the fish in this area before. These fish are critically important food resources for many predators, including fish on your dinner plate, like salmon and tuna, but also for animals like dolphins, whales, and penguins. This year, several countries issued fishing permits for access to the mesopelagic zone to provide fish feed and fish oil. Scientists are in a race to provide information about how we can make this harvest sustainable and what the impacts might be on our ecosystem. One key to this is understanding the predator-prey interactions. How do the top predators that are utilizing these resources find them? And how do these small fish, shrimp, and squid avoid getting eaten? So we learned that instead of being these messy aggregations of mixed species, these layers were actually highly organized, with individuals in schools, really, of the same size and type of animals. That these animals are organized as a predator avoidance response. When attacked by a predator, the schools compress, but their neighbors actually expand so that they maintain connection and a layer. That these animals are organized into groups, both schools and layers, is critical to how they survive in the open ocean. But it's also going to have a big impact on how the fishermen access them and how the ecosystem is impacted by fishing. We are about to start fishing the mesopelagic zone for the first time. So understanding like this is critical if we are to effectively manage those resources. History shows us that free-for-alls and fishing don't end well. It's a critical time for science to play a role.